our faith. The reason why you got to make sure you're under the right leadership, because again, you don't even know if God has removed his name, amen, if he's removed his name from that particular ministry or from that particular leader. Amen. We need to know, again, based on our relationship with God, we need to understand that, again, God said he's going to remove them from their land. Amen. And I don't know if I talked about it before, but sometimes you even find where a church or a ministry has lost their building. Amen. And again, sometimes you'll find where leaders are caught up in controversy. You know, all of a sudden their name is in the news. They're being exposed for doing this and doing that. And people say, well, that's a plight of the enemy. The enemy is against them. Amen. But I'm telling you that sometimes, amen, I'm not saying 100% of the time, but sometimes, amen, the enemy that you're talking about is God. God has put his hand off them and turned them over to a reprobate mind, have allowed them to be exposed, because just like he's saying here, I'm going to remove my name from you. Amen. I'm going to cast you out. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Glory be to God. He said, then I will uproot them from my land, which I have given them. In this house which I have sanctified for my name, I will cast out of my sight and make it a proverb and a byword among all people. And as for this house, which is exalted, everyone who passes by it will be astonished and say, why has the Lord done thus to this land and this house? Then they will answer, because they forsook the Lord God of their fathers, who brought them out of the land of Egypt and embraced other gods and worshiped them and served them. Therefore, he has brought all this calamity on them. And that's why it's, we can say God did it. See, when good things happen, it's easy to say God did it. When bad things happen, we say, no, 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 that's the devil. But I'm telling us, everything is not the devil. Amen. Every attack. Amen. That comes or calamity or tragedy, everything is not the devil. Hello, somebody. I'm talking about that place now. Amen. God did it. God did it. But here we find that they begin to serve other gods. What are you talking about? Sometimes, even in ministry today, we have made certain things gods to us. Amen. Sometimes we've made a building for us, our God. Sometimes we've made a building plan, our God. Sometimes we've made a wardrobe, our God. Sometimes we've made our sororities and fraternities, our God. Sometimes we've made our denomination, our God. And I'm telling you, he is a jealous God. And when we serve those other things, we are literally serving other gods. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. But we are serving other gods. And he has removed his hand. He has removed his name, amen. He cast this thing out of his sight, and he's made it a proverb and a byword. So it's important for us to know that not only is the leader affected, but also the people are affected by what the leader does, amen. But that's why, that's why we need to be in the right place, amen, where we can follow the leader as Solomon did David. Hallelujah, amen. Because David, even though David messed up, David yet had a heart after God. That's why some other ministries are still around. And people hear about it and we say, well, they messed up. That guy's messed up. But they still have a heart after God. And God's still working in them. Amen. God is still able to do something in their lives. Amen. God is still able to do some great things even through their ministry. Amen. Hallelujah, somebody. Now, I will tell you, on the other side, there are some ministries that are still in place, that are still active, amen, that God removed his hand from. I promise you that. Amen. That's why it's important for you to know where would God have you to be, and not base it on my tradition, not base it on a choir, not base it on, amen, a children's ministry, amen, but be in the place that God would have you to be. Be led by the Holy Ghost. Amen. But he said, once again, verse 22, then they will answer because they forsook the Lord their God, who brought them out of the land of Egypt and embraced other gods and worshiped them and served them. Therefore, he has brought all this calamity. God will bring some calamity. He will bring some destruction. Hallelujah. That place. Father, I bless you today, God. I thank you for even this line. I thank you for the ability, Father, to come before your people, Father, with prayer, with a word of God. And God, thank you that you're watching over your word to perform it. God, we heard this word that we ought to pray for one another. God, we often talk about, God, that we want you to heal our land. God, that we're going to turn from our wicked ways, Lord God. And God, I thank you, that Father, that this is our cry on today, God, that we are a people of prayer. God, that we're using the tools that you've given us, that we're calling on heaven, that we're pulling on heaven, God, that you would change our life, that you would change the impact of everything that's going on around us, Lord God. Even this very pestilence that we speak of, Lord God. Pestilence, God, that is destroying families, Lord God. Diseases, God, that is it's destroying people, Lord God. Father, not only cancer, not only HIV, but depression, Lord God. Suicide, Lord God. Father, the hands of the enemy running, rush out all these different drugs, Lord God. Father, methamphetamines, Lord God. Father, all these different acids that are corroding the hearts and minds of your people, God. God, we stand today believing, God, that you're going to shift our atmosphere, Lord God. Father, this thing shall not kill your people, God. We will not turn to a false God. God, we're not going to allow what we see, God, what we hear on the news to turn us away from the Lord God Almighty. God, we shall continue to call on Yahshua. God, we shall continue to plead the blood. God, we shall continue to call on Elohim, oh God. God, I thank you that Emmanuel, that God is with us, and God, we're not going to leave you. We thank you that you declared that you will never leave us nor forsake us, and we're not going to let go of your unchanging hand. We trust you in every part of our life, oh God. God, we give your name glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for this word. We thank you, God, that you will not have to make us a byword or a proverb, oh God. Father, you can write your name on us, Lord God, and we're going to stand firm as oak trees of righteousness. God, though the wind may come, oh God, we're going to remain rooted and stand firm in the faith, oh God. Thank you for making our feet as hinds feet, where we're able to stand and embrace whatever trials and tribulations that come our way. God, I thank you that we shall remain good examples, oh God. God, whether we are leaders or a follower, Lord God, for we all are accountable to somebody, oh God. God, I thank you that we are being who you called us to be. God, that we don't despise those that you placed over us, Lord God. God, that we shall follow them, Lord God, Father, for you said to obey, Lord God, your parents in the faith, Lord God. Whoever you call to be over us, God, we're going to be obedient to them. We're going to be faithful to them, Lord God. I thank you right now, even as Solomon was faithful to David, Lord God. I thank you, God, that you can establish some things on us, Lord God. But we're going to keep your statutes. We're going to keep your judgments, Lord God. And even when we don't know, God, we're yet seeking your face and saying, reveal it to me, God. Fix my heart. Fix my mind. Put your word in my heart, God, that I may not sin against thee, oh God. God, turn our minds away from all the other things, Lord God. I thank you that there's a people, God, that have a heart and a mind to follow Jesus. I thank you, God. We're not turning to false God. We're not turning to other gods. Hallelujah. We have not made anything else of God over us, for we know that you're jealous. I honor you today. And I thank you, God, for this time. I thank you for this people. And we bless you, God. Let us be that place. That place that you placed your name on. That place that you've chosen. That place that you sanctified. Make us, Lord God. Hallelujah. Us. For we are your bride, in the name of Jesus. God, I honor you, and I bless your holy name.